गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास एंड वेलकम ऑल फॉर दिस BEE सेशन. दिस इज आवर एटमोस्ट फर्स्ट लेक्चर इन विच वी आर गोइंग टू डील विद और डिस्कस विद द फंडामेंटल टर्म्स ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिसिटी लाइक EMF, इलेक्ट्रोमोटिव फोर्स, करंट, रेजिस्टेंस एंड पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस. बिफोर वी स्टार्टिंग द आवर एक्चुअल डिस्कशन, लेट्स नो few lines about a structure of atom, or we called a free electron. We are actually trying to understand the concept of free electron. We know that the most fundamental unit of all solids is an atom. It may be solid, liquid or gaseous, any form of matter. It consists of an atom, and it is very much important to study the structures. According to the modern electronic theory, atom is mainly composed of three fundamental particles, that is electron, proton and neutron. We done the discussion, and again on your screen we see in the electronic configuration of two different atoms. Number one is a hydrogen atom, let's say this figure A, and figure B is a silicon atom. But having a nucleus at the center core, yes of course, and the electrons are revolving in shell pattern, SHELL, or we called orbits. Okay, in hydrogen atom only one electron is there, but in silicon the atomic number 14 electrons are revolved around the nucleus, and their configurations, their divisions are like: in first orbit there are 2 electrons, in second again there are 8 electron, and in third or outermost, because there is no orbit again over that, okay, the 4 electron. It means these are 4. They can give the electron to another atom, they can adapt the electron from another atom to become an octet, to complete an their octet or fulfillment, okay. Or there is a third choice called covalency, sharing pairing, okay, leave it about. But the electron present in the outermost orbit is called a valence electron, or the shell which is outermostly present is called valence electron, valence shell, and the electron present in that valence orbit is called valence electron, okay. These electrons are loosely coupled, loosely connected with their parent nucleus, because as the distance goes on increasing, means let's say in Hindi hum agar ye orbit ke bare mein baat karenge, ye do electron ke bare mein baat karenge, these are tightly coupled, ye inke beech mein ka jo force of attraction hai zyada hai as compared to the this third or valence electron orbit, okay. So these electron, after a few application of a small quantity of force, external force, these electrons are having an ability to become free. They can easily become free from their parent nuclei and come to the part of the conduction, okay. That's why we called these electron as a free electron. And only atoms, only metals can carry the current, because they have an ability, or actually or practically they having a number of free electrons present within them, which are the real responsibility, or carries the responsibility to carry the current, okay. So the material in which a quantity of free electron are measured, they supposed to be the conductor to carry the current within them, okay. That's the whole idea of free electron and electrons present in the metals only, okay. And if, on the other hand, if there is no free electron present in an atom, then atom is not said to be able to carry current, and such atom we called such material we called insulator or bad conductors, okay. Now let's move our discussion towards a relation between charges and current, okay. So charge can be measured in coulomb, and 1 coulomb charge कैरीज 6.24 इंटू 10 टू द पावर 18 ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन. इलेक्ट्रॉन आर द नेगेटिवली चार्ज कैरियर. वी नो ऑल दिस थियरी बिहाइंड द इलेक्ट्रॉन प्रोटॉन एंड न्यूक्लियस कॉन्फिग्रेशन एंड ऑल दिस. ओके नाउ वी लिटिल बिट मूव टूवर्ड्स द EMF एंड देन अगेन स्विच अवर डिस्कशंस टूवर्ड्स द करंट. ओके सो फर्स्ट सी द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ इलेक्ट्रोमोटिव फोर्स. टू अंडरस्टैंड दिस कॉन्सेप्ट फर्स्ट वी नीड अ पीस और लेट्स से रफली वी कैन से अ पीस ऑफ अ कंडक्टर एनी क्रॉस सेक्शन ऑफ एन कंडक्टर बॉडी. देन इन दैट बॉडी वी फाइंड लॉट्स ऑफ और अ बिलियन ट्रिलियन quantities of free electron which are randomly moving because the electron have its own tendency to move anywhere within a conducting body or within the boundary of that conductor piece. Okay, so electron freely or randomly move inside a conductor piece, but if we apply a small quantity of electric cell over there across this conductor piece, or we can, in another word, if this conductor piece is subjected to some fixed energy sources like in this DC battery, this is the symbol of a battery. Okay, if you connect this piece with a battery, then what happens? Due to the force exerted by the battery, the electron which are present in the conductor piece, which actually moves randomly, but after application or due to electric cell application, this electron gets fixed direction. And which is this direction? Electrons moves from negative of the terminal of a battery toward the positive, because we know unlike charges attract each other. Electrons are negative in nature, so they attract towards the positive terminal of a battery. Okay, so the practical direction of electron flow is from negative to the positive terminal of a battery. But conventionally, or for the sake of our understanding or for the nomenclature to defining or symbolic representation, we say conductor current within a conductor flows from positive terminal of a battery to the negative terminal of a battery. There is a controversy. Controversy of what? Controversy of direction of electron flow of current and conventional direction of current flow. Electron flow of current is always from negative toward the positive terminal, and the conventional direction is exactly opposite that of flow of electron. That means it from positive terminal of a battery to the negative terminal of a battery. Due to the application of cell or force, the electron gets a definite direction and flow of that electron in a definite direction within a conducting body is called current. Okay, so nextly we will see the relation or the definition of EMF. Okay, the definition of EMF. EMF stand for electromotive force, the long form of EMF, and the unit is volt. It measured in volt. EMF, all the metal contains a large number of free electron, we know that, which move randomly in all the directions inside the metal piece. We seen that theory. Again, if you apply a battery or voltage source, then the free electron will move in a particular direction. This electrical force or the pressure that causes the free electron to move in a particular direction is called electromotive force. ओके एन इलेक्ट्रिकल एफर्ट रिक्वायर्ड टू ड्रिफ्ट अ फ्री इलेक्ट्रॉन और मूव द फ्री इलेक्ट्रॉन इन पर्टिकुलर डायरेक्शन इज कॉल्ड इलेक्ट्रोमोटिव फोर्स. ओके द नेगेटिवली चार्ज कैरियर्स दैट इज इलेक्ट्रॉन आर अट्रैक्टेड टूवर्ड्स द पॉजिटिव टर्मिनल ऑफ अ बैटरी. ओके एंड द सेम वाइज द कन्वेंशनली वी सेज द करंट फ्लो फ्रॉम पॉजिटिव टर्मिनल टू द नेगेटिव टर्मिनल ऑफ अ बैटरी. The unit of EMF is volt. It is also called voltage or potential differences. Okay, we will see the concept of current first and then discuss about the potential difference later on. Okay, so the movement of electron is from negative to the positive, while the movement of current is always assumed from positive to the negative direction, and this direction is called conventional direction of current. Okay, now let's give a brief discussion about the relation between charge and current. The current is flow of electron, we know all this, not only the flow in a particular direction after application of EMF. The current can be measured by measuring how many electrons are passing through a material per second. It is the average quantity. Okay, we can't say one current flow, two current flow, because instead of that we take the average of how much the charge is flow per unit second within that conducting body, and this term is mathematically expressed as the current denoted by letter capital I, and I is equal to Q by T. That is, the charge is indicated by Q coulombs, while current is indicated by I, and the unit for the current is ampere, which is a coulomb per second. Again, here by this derivation, I is equal to Q by T. Okay. Now, I is the average quantity of current flow. Q is the total charge which transfer through a metal conductor per time required to transfer the charge. So, we can define a definition of 1 ampere should be a current of 1 ampere is said to be flow in a conductor when a charge of 1 coulomb is passing in at any given point in the conductor at t seconds. Okay, now we move towards the concept of electric potential. Generally or very roughly hum potential ko kya keh sakte hai, to potential is nothing but energy to do work or ability of that matter to do work. Okay, let's say when two similar charged particles are brought near, the ability of a charged particle to do work is called electric potential. The unit of potential is volt, and mathematically it could be expressed like electric potential is work done per unit charge. It means the electric potential at a point due to a charge is 1 volt. If 1 joule of work is to be done in bringing a unit positive charge, that is a positive charge of 1 coulomb, from infinity to that places, or we can say if the two charges are like charges, then there will be a force of repulsion. And this force of repulsion, it needs to some energy to repel from each other. That energy is called a potential. And differences at their energy levels, let's say one charge is a 7 coulomb charge and another charge is a 2 coulomb charge, then this differences in the charge coulombs is called a potential difference. And this potential difference should be denoted by voltage at AB, which is equals to voltage at A minus voltage at B with unit volt, and it mathematically is expressed as electric potential is equal to work done per unit charge. Work done expressed by letter W, and charges are measured in coulomb. Okay, so joule per charge or joule per coulomb should be the unit. Okay, but generally we refer electric potential in volt. Okay, and the potential difference. Now, the difference is between their potential value is called a potential. If the potential at point A is higher than point B, then we can say voltage at point A is greater than voltage at point B, and their potential difference will be a positive one. If the reverse case, if the potential at point A is lower than potential at point B, then potential at point A is less than B, this potential difference is said to be negative. Now, the effect of the potential differences. The main effect of potential difference is the flow of electric current from a point of higher potential to a point of lower potential. If the two points are connected to each other with a conducting wire, if the potential difference between two points is zero, if there is no difference at their energy levels, then there will be no current should flow within that conductor. Okay, now move our discussions toward the technical definition of current. So the current is defined as the flow of electron. Higher the number of flowing electron, higher is the value of current, but each electron carries a constant charge on it. We can define the current as the flow of charge per unit area, which is given as I is equal to Q by T. Now the term which is come in picture, that is called resistance. Okay, so resistance is the property of a material due to which that material offers opposition, or it opposes the flow of current through them. Okay, that called the resistance. And a resistance having unit ohm, a resistance denoted by letter R, as like current is denoted by letter I, potential difference is denoted by PD, unit is volt, resistance unit is ohm. We may know about this one. Okay, then our syllabus mentioned the laws of resistance. Okay, so what are these laws of resistances? Before we going to discuss a law of a resistance, first we should know about the factors affecting the resistance of a material. The first factor which affect the value of quantity of resistance is length of that material. The resistance of a material is directly proportional to the length. It means longer the wire, more will be the resistance. Shorter the wire, resistance will be less. Second is cross-sectional area. The resistance of material is inversely proportional to the cross-section area of a material. It means a cross-section area allowed the passage of more number of free electron, offering less resistance. The cross-section area is denoted by letter A. Jitna zyada cross-section area hoga, utna kam resistance hoga. दूसरे बात ऐसे कर सकते हैं कि रेजिस्टेंस अगर बढ़ गया था उसका मीनिंग है कि क्रॉस सेक्शन एरिया कम है. देन थर्ड पॉइंट इज द टाइप ऑफ अ नेचर ऑफ अ मटेरियल. इट मीन्स द नेचर मटेरियल कैसे बना है. आइदर इट इज़ अ प्योर फॉर्म ऑफ अ मटेरियल और इट इज अ काइंड ऑफ अलॉय हैविंग ओवर देयर. ओके, दैट ऑल्सो कॉन्ट्रीब्यूट फॉर अफेक्टिंग द रेजिस्टेंस वैल्यू. एंड द फोर्थ वन इज द टेम्परेचर. The temperature of material affect the value of resistance. Generally, the resistance of material increases as increasing temperature. Generally, effect of small change in the temperature on the resistance is not considered, as it is negligibly small. So, by basis of this, we can write mathematically here the resistance denoted by letter capital R, which is directly proportional to the length of the material and inversely proportional to the area of cross section. The effect of the nature of a material is considered through the constant of proportionality, and which is denoted by letter rho, RHO, the letter shown in here the picture. Okay, if I make it some colorful manner, then this rho, I've chosen it. Okay, this is the room. No doubt. Okay. Nothing. Okay. Then the relation is given by R is equal to rho into L by A, where L is the length of the conductor in meter, A cross section area in square meter, rho resistivity in ohm meter, and R is the resistance of ohms. Then the law said this is, that is, the resistance is directly proportional to the length of the conductor, inversely proportional to the area of cross section, proportionality constant called resistivity rho, and the definition of resistivity is, the resistivity is also called the specific resistance of a material, yes it is true, which is depend upon the nature of material and denoted by the rho. And the expression for this one is rho is equal to Ra into L, that is with unit R having unit ohm, A meter square, L m meter, so it becomes ohm meter. Okay, and the definition, the resistance of a material having unit length and unit area of cross section is called its specific resistance or resistivity of that material. It having a different for the different material. Okay. Now we will stop over here, and in our next lecture we will discuss the resistances in series and resistances in parallel combinations. Okay, that's it. Thank you.